Finding homes has never been easier. The impact of technology in the real estate and hospitality industry is quickly being realized by tourists and homeowners. But managing these homes is still difficult. There needs to be a better way to manage homes without using a lot of hassle and without having a lot of people involved. That's why we created Vicayo, a better way to lease and manage short-term rental management. I'm Truth Oladapo, CEO of Vicayo. And in the next 3 minutes, we're going to find out if you guys can handle the truth. Vicayo is more than just getting a rent every month. We're about impacting and helping homeowners, whether it's first-time buyers or veteran landlords. That's why we've taken the hassle by using Superhost and furnishing spaces in just 72 hours. Who are Superhost? Well, Superhost are people like you and I who are passionate about the short-term rental industry. They're experts on platforms like VRBO, HomeAway, or Airbnb. I know you guys love fast-growing markets. Ours is growing by 35% year over year. I also know that you've all heard of Airbnb. They're huge. But what you don't realize is that Airbnb has less than 4% of second homes in the U.S. Think about it. Just 4%. We're going after the 6 million plus homes that are not online to meet the growing demand. And these homes we're adding would help the industry grow to over $200 billion by 2021, as predicted by the experts. We're best in our competition because we've been hosting since couch surfing, even before Airbnb was founded. And we're using this experience to stay ahead of the curve. We have 2.3 million in ARR, and we are profitable. And we're excited about continuing this pace and growing quickly. We've brought on some advisors in the hospitality industry. Kirby Winfield sold his company Dwellable to HomeAway, now part of Expedia. And Garrett Cohen is running one of the largest insurance companies in the U.S. They're helping us to remove and eliminate some of the processes and the risk involved in the traditional property management industry. Since 500 startups, we've raised over $950K, and we are raising funds to improve our onboarding and reduce our CapEx. And we want to improve the machine learning on our rent, quoting, and Superhost matching tool, as well as our API. As immigrant and American-born founders, we are uniquely positioned to address this market better than anyone. I was born in Nigeria, where you didn't only have to deal with being robbed by gunpoint. I survived a few of those. But my brothers and I would wake up to sores from rats biting our toes at night. Things got better when we came to the U.S. at 13 with my brother. At 15, I graduated high school, and I worked with people flipping homes. I was too young to get a job. I was fortunate to end up at Columbia University, and I graduated college with economics, physics, and engineering degrees. I then went on to work on Wall Street, where I cut my teeth working for Deutsche Bank. My co-founder, she grew up in a home with a real estate attorney father, who was always needed in leases. She learned very early on that landlords hate vacancy risk. Since we met as roommate, she convinced me to rent our spare bedroom, and soon after, we were growing our business organically, sometimes furnishing homes for next to nothing on Craigslist. As repeat founders, we learned that speed mattered. And this mindset has allowed us to reach profitability quickly. If you're looking to help people earn financial freedom using real estate, then congratulations, you found the right thing. Go on republic.co/vkl and invest today. Thank you.
So we're going to open up a couple questions here. You mentioned, I know that your co-founder has been on our show, called in on the Saturday show, and we invested some money then. You might get a repeat investment today.
Yeah, that'd be great.
How much money have you guys done in revenue this or on pace for this year or last year?
This year we're on pace for 3.2. We've done about 300K January and February. And last year we did 2.1.
So to give you guys kind of a sense of where they are in the scope of business. Any questions from the community?
Yep. Well, Airbnb is not a competitor. A lot of people confuse that. Airbnb, they're just a platform. They don't manage and they don't furnish listing. And that's where we're specialized. And we don't do what they do, which is actually. We get our people. Yes, so we're growing differently. If you think about why, some reasons why Airbnb can do what we do, regulation is one of those reasons. We're growing based on those regulations from the ground up. Airbnb is too big now to enter certain place because then they go from advertiser to a manager who has to follow the law and they have to do it everywhere. So that creates the complication that, you know, they didn't grow specifically. But they still need homes. So they're doing whatever they can to enable a company like us, partner with a company like us, to get more homes on their platform.
So,
yes, right now we're a service, but we're also growing to become a platform. Like when you think of all the things, all the human power that's involved, right? A super host, a maintenance person, a designer, all of those people are going to be part of our platform later. Today it's just a service from super host. We're helping landlords. In the future, there are all the people that are going to plug in to make it all happen.
One of the areas I think was really interesting to me, and I'm blanking on, I think it was, doesn't matter now. I can't remember who had the guest host at the time we did the show. Definitely have to remember. It's Fuda.
Yeah.
It was Shane Jones, the co-founder of Fuda, who was on the show. One of the things that was really interesting about what your business does is for landlords who have spaces that are empty, that they otherwise would have absolutely no way of monetizing. That, to me, is the big hook in this. They can bring in stuff from Wayfair, which they get on a discount on its own. They put it into an empty unit that landlords previously never would have been able to Airbnb because they would have had to set it out. They would do a whole ton of stuff, management, fill it out, put a chair, put a bed, all this stuff. They handle all that. So literally within 72 hours, you could have seven empty spaces in your tower that you run that you would have never even considered Airbnb because it just would have been too much work. And 72 hours later, fill it up with furniture and so forth and manage soup to nuts the entire process. So they're basically sucking up all of the real estate that's currently not even considered Airbnb usable, so to speak.
That's the key of what we're doing, and that's the uniqueness, is that when you think of Airbnb, they're so big. And that's what I say. Everyone's heard of them. But you don't realize that only everyone who has thought of Airbnb, who had the ability to do an Airbnb, just about have done it. And now you have people who are like, I want to do a rental. I didn't even want to do a rental. I wanted to buy a property to make money and have this safe investment. But I have to at least meet someone once a year, twice a year, to sign the lease, make sure repairs are done, and then I don't want to see them again. I want to keep getting my check. So what we're doing is saying, you can keep doing that. We will come in and we will do all the work. But not only are we going to guarantee you your base, we're going to let you share part of this new economy. And you get a little bit more, but you still don't do anything. In fact, you do less than you did before. Because now you just get a check, we do all the management, and we keep the upside.
We actually had a call-in on that show who is a guy who makes 250,000 soda sales as an quote, full-time job. He's like 37 years old, so he says. And drives an Uber basically back and forth to properties which he owns and just collects rent on. And dude makes six figures just renting his life out.
One of our superheroes does that. One of our superheroes is actually he's not an Uber driver. He's a Turo. He has five cars on Turo that he rents out, and then also helps with Airbnb. And you know, it's just this gig economy is where you know you can just make money doing you know alternative things, and you don't have to keep a job, whether it's Uber or Airbnb. I mean, even when we started, when Isabel came to me, you know, she walked in and was like, "We need to figure something out to make more money." I was like, well, there's a million things you can do to make money. I've been doing this since I was 10. And she was like, what can we do now? And I thought she was, like, joking. And then there's a few things we could do. They hear these 10 things, and I'm a nerd. So I've been researching Airbnb and all these companies. And I was like, well, we can do this. It's just like, which one can we do, like, literally today? I want to quit my job. Like, I was like, okay, we could do the car rental or Airbnb.
But we have a space. And she's like, yeah, we have a space.
So Airbnb made more sense. So that's where we went with our model. And I also was passionate about it. So I was like, you know, I actually would enjoy doing this. So when we started, that's one of the things that, you know, we started doing is helping people who have lease. From a technology standpoint, it's a little bit more complicated. But it's one of the most needed service. So, you know, we started out with helping even just roommates from one room to another. So that's something that we want to grow quickly so we can do now because it's very complicated. I mean, when we started, it was just room to room. We would, for 1 year, and this is how I thought, like, I would do this as long as you're, like, all in. And she's like, yeah, sure. I was like, okay, the next year, we wouldn't know where we spend the night. On any given night, until 8 p.m., someone could book our place. And if someone books our place, we're off to New Jersey, to a hotel, or something else to kind of like just build the business. So it was crazy. We had all kinds of people sent it there, celebrities, models. Everyone was testing Airbnb. So it was like we had like a supermodel like showed up to our house one day, Anouk. And I was like, are you kidding me? Like, this is what we're going to spend the next few days with. But it was just like everyone was really into Airbnb. But any given night, we would just put our place there. We had a family member that got discounted in the hotel, so we put our place for more than we would pay for an hotel. So for like a year, we just kept doing this room by room, but it was complicated. And that's when we knew, okay, we had to simplify it, and we went with the whole house model, building the technology for the single room model.
Very cool. We're going to kick on to the next one, and then we will, of course, if you guys want to have questions and stuff,